Good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Rajya Sabha News. Let's begin the bulletin with the headlines. Rajya Sabha passes Right to Information Amendment Bill 2019. House rejects motion to refer bill to select committee with 117 members voting against it and only 75 in its favour. Congress and other parties stage walkout after division of votes. Many issues of national interest raised in the upper house. Problems caused by drought in several states, including Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Environmental pollution highlighted during the zero hour. And five new members take oath in Rajya Sabha. Members from Tamil Nadu include MDMK founder Vaiko, PMK leader Anbumani Ramadas, and two candidates each from AIADMK and DMK. Parliament approved the amendment to the RTI Act with Rajya Sabha passing it on Thursday. The bill was passed in the upper house by voice vote after negating an opposition-sponsored motion to send it to a House committee for greater scrutiny. The motion was negated by 117 members voting against the motion and 75 members voting in favour. Earlier, replying to the debate on the amendment, Minister Jitendra Singh said that the amendment was not brought without any motivation and was in good faith. This, he said, will lead to institutionalization of Chief Information Commission and strengthen the provision of RTI Act.
This legislation or this amendment is being brought in without any motivation, in good faith. There are a number of other tribunals which have been sought to be harmonized in the last few months. There are also been occasions when the court has directed to bring in uniformity, streamlining, institutionalizing, and I'm sure at the end of the day this will lead to more of streamlining, more of institutionalizing of the chief the information commission, and that in process would also strengthen the provision of the RTI Act.
And members of various political parties took part in the debate and put forth several suggestions.
This RTI has become the NRTI, not the Right to Information Act, with this amendment. It has actually trying to control by a control freak government this enactment through seemingly very simple changes.
RTI ka 2017-2018 mein budget tha 23.61 crore. और 18-19 में बजट घटा करके जो इस आरटीआई पर खर्च होता था वो कर दिया गया 8.66 करोड़। ये इनकी निष्ठा है, पहले भाग नहीं लेंगे जब उस बनेगा उसमें बहस में, ना अमेंडमेंट देंगे, ना संशोधन देंगे, ना बहस करेंगे, ना सुझाव देंगे, और जब बन गया और सरकार में आए तो उसका बजट घटाना शुरू कर दिया।
यू गिव मी द एश्योरेंस दैट इट विल नॉट इंपैक्ट द इंडिपेंडेंस व्हिच आई डिड नॉट बिलीव, आई हैव गिव माय ओन रीजंस. But I still believe that it will not impact the independence. Whatever we are trying to say, the public perception is we have brought it down, the status of the commission. But that also, you think that you will take care of it, and you also assured us that it will not impact the independence, on which we are very, very much concerned.
केंद्र के चुनाव आयोग के निर्णय सुप्रीम कोर्ट में चैलेंज होते रहे हैं. मैं पूछना चाहता हूं कि जिनके ऑर्डर ही चैलेंज होते रहे हैं उनको कैसे सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जज के बराबर और हाई कोर्ट के जज के बराबर मान्यता दी जाएगी. किसी भी स्थिति में उनको इस पर मान्यता नहीं दी जानी चाहिए.
Whereas Central Information Commissioner and State Information Commissioners are statutory bodies established under the provisions of the Right to Information Act 2005. Therefore, their status and service conditions need to be considered and rationalized accordingly. Sir, by these amendments, the Right to Information Act will not be diluted as feared by some people.
strength of the commissioners. Definitely, the central government will take care of it. We cannot be take it as a constitutional guarantee. It is only a statutory right. So, being a mere statutory right, one cannot claim any absolute right. So, it is not being absolute right. The government is rightly bringing the bill.
Over the last 14 years, as you look at the right to information, it has created history. And sir, today, right to information should not be seen from the prism of either politics or political parties, sir. We believe that right to information is critical to the overall governance and the development of the country. RTI has been one of the hallmark legislations going forward, sir.
जब बहुत बड़ी मेजॉरिटी आती है, the temptation is to usher in authoritarian state. Please resist that temptation in the interest of the people, in the interest of the activists, in the interest of citizens of this country who had got empowered because of this instrument called right to information, sir.
You are diluting the powers of the authority. Sir, the powers now which are vested with the state, one by one, this government, the NDA government, is trying to grab the powers and usurp the powers of the states, sir, one by one.
Government could easily block requests if details show the government in poor light. Can this be done? Can this not be done? This is one very important, sir. Sir, what about the pendency of cases? What about the budget cut of 38%? Sir, all these are realities.
And five newly elected Rajya Sabha MPs took oath as members of Rajya Sabha on Thursday. Five members, including MDMK founder Vaiko, PMK leader Anbumani Ram Dos, and two candidates each from the AIADMK and the DMK, were elected unopposed as Rajya Sabha members from Tamil Nadu earlier this month. When the House met for the day, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu called for oath or a formation of the new members. After taking oath, the new members were warmly greeted by Naidu and other members in the House by thumping of desks. With the election of the six MPs, the AIADMK will have 10 members in the Rajya Sabha, while the DMK will have 5. The MDMK and PMK will have 1 member each in the Rajya Sabha from Tamil Nadu. And members raised issues of national interest in the Rajya Sabha in zero hour. BJP MP CM Ramesh raised the issue of drought in several states, including Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, while Satya Narayan Jatia called for action on environmental pollution.
According to the Indian Meteorological Department, rain deficit in southern peninsula has risen to around 28%, which is the highest among all 4 subdivisions in the country. As many as 7 subdivisions in the south, including Rayalaseema, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Marathwada and Vidarbha, are facing rain deficit. The rains are extremely crucial for the rain-fed kharif crops planted during this time. Farmers are finding it difficult to irrigate land as they have to start the process of cultivation of kharif season.
I seek to draw the kind attention of this August House that, as per reports, Defence Ministry is planning to shift Lebong Military Hospital of Darjeeling to other states, that is Assam, Arunachal Pradesh. This unfortunate shifting will hit hard on the retired Gorkha personnel. Furthermore, sir, there is no ECHS. Therefore, if this sole hospital will serve as a lifeline to the retired Gorkha personnel.
मैं जलवायु के प्रदूषण की समस्याओं की विभिषिका की ओर सदन का ध्यान आकर्षित कर रहा हूँ. निरंतर जलवायु में जो प्रदूषण हो रहा है उसके कारण से हमारा प्रकृति का संतुलन निरंतर बिगड़ते चला जा रहा है. मौसम बदल रहे हैं, समय पर वर्षा नहीं होती है और समय पर वर्षा नहीं होने के कारण से हमारी जो कृषि है वह प्रभावित होती है।
ये बात सही है कि डॉक्टरों की कमी है। अभी डिब्रूगढ़, अभी सोशल मीडिया में चल रहा था कि डिब्रूगढ़ राजधानी में एक महिला ने बच्चे को जन्म दिया, तो वहाँ की जो जितनी यात्रा कर रही महिलाएं थी उसने उनकी मदद की। मैं माननीय मंत्री, आपके माध्यम से माननीय मंत्री जी से ये मांग करना चाहती हूँ कि डॉक्टरों की कमी है, ठीक है, लेकिन फर्स्ट एड उनको मुहैया कराया जाए, ताकि जो सफ़र कर रही महिलाएं, इस तरह की महिलाएं हैं, उनको कुछ ना कुछ राहत मिल सके।
जबरन धर्म परिवर्तन कराने की प्रवृत्ति पुलवामा एयर स्ट्राइक के बाद ज़्यादा बढ़ गई। पाकिस्तान के उमरकोट रहीम यार खान, सांगड़, सकवर मिठी, अमरकोट, नगर पारकर, थार पारकर जैसे इलाकों से हमारे राजस्थान के जोधपुर में भील और मेघवाल परिवार के कई परिवार इस दौरान आए हैं। वहाँ ये भी सामने आया है कि गुरुद्वारे में घुसकर सिखों को बाहर किया गया, जिसके लिए प्रदर्शन हुआ।
And during the question hour in the Rajya Sabha, Minister of State for Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions, Dr. Jitendra Singh informed the House that the percentage of vacancies in various departments of the government has come down from 16% to 11% in the last 6 years. He also said that the process of filling up of 4 lakh posts is underway.
Vacancies 300, which are mentioned by the honorable member, you see, cumulatively the number of vacancies in 17-18 was 683,823, out of which, and this pertains mainly to those which are being dealt by the SSC, the Railway Board, and some of them the UPSC. Out of these, almost half, that means 3,89,069, almost 4 lakh, were already in the process of being filled up.
And replying to a question related to textile parks, Textiles Minister Smriti Irani said that efforts are being made by the government to improve textile parks across the country.
As the House may be aware, the Honorable Finance Minister also made a proposal to both Houses of Parliament of setting up manufacturing zones. We would like to then, sir, curtail our efforts with that of the Ministry of Finance to see how, under the new scheme presented by the Honorable Finance Minister, we can enhance our manufacturing capacities within these parks. Overall, the country, sir, close to 3,64,000 people are currently employed in these textile parks.
Thank you.
And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching.